Warm up, first run of the day. First run of the day. Lots of sustain, I like it. Ironclad sustain basically means I could take on anything that I choose, nothing can stop me. I would like to see you try, kind of thing. Ain't nothing gonna stop me. Like to see you try, sir. I got carnage in the dream, sir. It's alright. Stuff like that happens. Some AoE-ish, and some vulnerable. It goes well with carnage. I like this. The pain's not too bad because I have the sustain for it. Let's go this way. Pain's not too bad. We can work around the pain pretty well. Combust is really good. I like it. Let's go ahead and upgrade this bad boy. Let's go to the shop and then remove the pain and we're good. It's KO, game over. Reckless charge is not bad. I don't know if I need it though. I don't know. I don't mind reckless charge. I think it's nice, but you know, I'll pass. Let's go see or maybe remove the pain. Got a flame barrier. Ooh. Got a shovel I can't buy. Ooh. Oh, oi, we lay with the tier 1 sub. Appreciate it so much, man. Appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you, brother. Welcome to the germ pool. Ninjak was great. Ah, we lay. Aguanile! You guys know that song? Please tell me you guys know Aguanile. Please tell me you guys know Aguanile. Fire breathing trooper. It's like a trooper, but why bottle flame? A little bit awkward, this bottle flame, but I'll take it. Raul! Alright, I'll play Aguanile for you guys. My name pronounced fully French. Let me play Aguanile for you guys. It is copyrighted, so we're gonna take a little break. Give me a sec. It'll be a quick little break. Hemo versus dual wheel though. What's dual wheel good for here, guys? Hey, thank you, man. Appreciate it. Welcome to Slay the Spire. It's a great game. Dual's not that great here. And Hemokinesis? It's not a bad attack, I'll be honest. Hemokinesis is not a bad attack. So we have a lot of self-damaging cards, though. Alright, real quick. Let's take a break right before this. Play Aquagina for you guys. Check this shit out. For you guys who haven't heard this, you're missing out. The tongues are way superior, absolutely. The wiki said, if the wiki's wrong, then we should change the wiki. The tongues are so good. So many circumstances where the tongues are amazing. With Snekawai, with Fusion Hammer. I mean, the tongues are amazing, brother. So change the wiki for me. Say Jeremiah said so. Guys, get ready to dance, alright? Guys, get ready to dance. Chuck it with snake wise would be nice. I mean, helps with our energy. I upgraded feed. Oh, that's so good. Wait, this should have been like a flex pot. It's a flex pot because I just want to get the feed off. Ooh, we got strength pot. Clothesline for the weekend, absolutely. And we have snuck wise, so weak that the cost of that is variable. Okay, now we just need anything from this. This event's amazing. Anything from this event is good. Absolutely. That's probably one of the worst ones though, out of the options. So I'm about to hit a shop, so I don't know if I want to do this. I guess I could skip the shop, remove a card and upgrade a card. I would remove a strike and upgrade something random. Or transform two cards randomly. Let's do remove and upgrade. Upgraded feed. Yes, the game knows what I love. The game knows what I got. Two combust for this fight, and I got flame barrier opening hand. I mean, you don't gotta say much more. This is what I'm talking about. This is what I'm talking about. Wow. Shockwave, yes. This is violence, speed, momentum in Slay the Spire. Fast paced, carnage. It's all the good things. We got Nunchaku here. People don't understand. I do want to try to get feed off here. So do this 6 plus. 45 plus 21, 66. Yo, thank you so much. Inhumane Jekyll with the tier 1, 16 months. Wow, man. Damn, it's a long time. Thank you. So what was that math? I was at 66. We're at 66, huh? Easy 6 plus 6, 72. If I do strength pot, I can get feed off here. I think it's worth, man. Let's get my feet off. I don't want to huss and fuss too much. I don't want to huss and fuss too much. Just want my feet and get out. Now I just need to zoom. Let's try to stack up Nunchaku as much as we can. Next boss, I'm getting potions left and right, I don't know why. Second win is interesting, but not quite ready for this deck, I don't think. Alright, first elite, let's go. Flame Bear is in the deck. Flame Bear is in the deck, but we all want to play Carnage, so this is tough because we don't want to lose Carnage, one of our best attacks, but, you know, we do have Flame Bearers, which is good damage. Okay, Wile Aguanile giving a sub to Digaro. Appreciate it, man. Thank you. Very generous. Thank you. Thank you, dude. So we lose our Carnage, which is not good. Senko was not kind on that turn. This is a fight where you do shrink putt, to be honest. You don't want to take any chances. Senko wasn't kind on that turn either. Senko's a little bit more kind on this turn. I think it was a little bit more kind. Oh, I think I just use feed now and I don't try to get it. I mean, okay. I mean, how greedy is it for me to go for feed? Because, like, okay, I can do Flame Barrier next turn and then he hurts himself, he gets really low, and then I can feed on the following turn. Or I could just do feed now and try to kill him next turn with attacks. Alright, we'll try to go for feet. We'll be greedy here. Take 8 damage. Flame Barrier on this turn. And then he's gonna go ahead and be nice and low for feet. And exactly as I said it would happen, it happened. Alright, so it was not bad. Bronze skills. Guys, I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's confirmation biased. Every time I fight the Gremlin, sorry, I fight Book of Stabbing, he drops something that was good for him, like Bronze Scales or Flame Barrier. And there's like, maybe it's purely confirmation bias. Yeah, I can imagine so, but damn, that's incredible. Alright, another Elite and another Dream. I do want to get Combust going. We could rest, get some value to the fact that our max HP is quite high, but we have a Flex Pot, we have 62 life. I think I'm going to get Combust upgraded and increase our AoE power for things like this. For a fight like this. Again, we're losing Carnage. And again, we're losing Carnage. And I got to ask myself, if I had Nunchaku stacked, Carnage into feed, maybe? This is called Info Mod. It's not currently in the workshop. You can't find it on the workshop. And, tells you the available chances and the events coming up, tells you all this stuff, but it's not in the workshop. You got to find it and put it into one of your folders. I'll help you with that in a sec. We're losing Carnage again. Do I just pop it and take the damage? That's a lot of damage to take, huh? Twenty-eight damage is quite a hefty hit. I'm taking 21 to my face to do 28. Or I could block 19 more. So I take only 2 damage to the face, but I lose 28 damage. Ugh. Now I'm weakened. We got Combust out though. I'm playing very defensive, which is funny, but Combust does good work in this fight. Big yikes. Big yikes. Now I gotta get feed off. We're about to be vulnerable. This is gonna be a very painful turn. I gotta get feed or kill here. Alright, I didn't get feed or kill here. Luckily, I am able to rest. Come on, these guys die to combust. Well played, Jeremy. Well played. I like that. That was a good play, Jeremy. Not bad, man. I thought that was really decent. Good job, Jeremy. All right. So now we have dual wield as an option. Now dual wield is interesting because of Enchiridion. Snekawai Enchiridion. Let me explain what happens. So what happens is you get a zero cost power, and dual wield in your opening hand is likely to show up sometimes, or at least a little bit more likely because you have a lot of cards roll. In which case you could either dual wield this cheap attack that Snekawai made cheap, like a zero cost Carnage, or a zero cost power and get double the power. Dual wield is very powerful. It also can hit feed and get double the feed, double the scaling. Double the scaling means you're healthier going into the heart and all the important fights. Singing Bowl, I do not mind. I'm going to rest my little booty. And now there's a world where I do... There's a world where I do upgrade here, like Shockwave or Dual Wield. Or I could just rest and fight another lead. Let's rest, keep it safe, keep it simple. Evolve is very good in this fight. And Carnage is nice and cheap. I could kill that guy. I'll do this though. Things like Bronze Skills and Carnage. Bronze Skills and Combust can kill that guy. Or just that, I guess. You know, Ninjaku is nice and stacked. This is an example of dual wield and bash, for instance, to get some extra damage. Not bad. Wait to feed him. I'm gonna try to feed this guy. I want to stack Ninjaku in the process, but I gotta be careful because I do have Flame Bearer and Combust, so I might have killed myself. Oh, beautiful. Nice feeds. Feed is so good. Funeral Pain is fantastic. Let's go. Round two, but I have Bronze Skills this time and a Flame Bearer. Good luck, buddy. Carnage is expensive. I also have... So here's what I do here. I use this like this because it's important that I keep that. I'll use Brutality. That's fine. I'll get rid of something I don't care about, like Dual Wield at this point. I can draw... the reason why getting Dual Wield is important because I want to draw into Flame Bearers more often. This is fine. We drew into Flame Bearer at the wrong time. A little unfortunate, but... What can you do? He still takes, you know, 11 damage to the face. Flame Bearer is at the wrong time yet again. But what can you do? Now I get self-forming clay, exactly. Waste of sundial, okay, but I want to get feed, which is the most important. And what do you know? I got feed. I got feed. Sorry to the chocolate, but feed is important. And boys, oh boys, oh boys, are we killing it or what? Are we max HPing it up or what, guys? What's up? I appear to be a villain. This is a winning run. It's a winning Ironclad run is what it is. How much does feed do here? 18, right? But if I do strike, he gets 3, and then I do this. So he's going to be... Alright, let's take a look. He's going to be at 20, and then I do 2 damage, and he has 4 block. So he's at 18 with 4, and then this is going to be 18. So it's... I'm short. How do I get rid of that? Oh, shit, that's so cool. That's so cool. I'm short, 4 damage. I gotta draw back into feed. Damn, he kills himself. That's sad. Skip. Alright. An early shockwave, that's not bad. I can dual wield the evolve, which doesn't really do much. I can just use Carnage and not Shockwave then. But I think Shockwave is too much value. This is tough, because I think Shockwave is too much value. But Carnage is also pretty decent. You just finished watching my Mad Scientist run? That's an old one, isn't it? Let me use the bathroom real quick. Too much YouTube, eh? Carnage versus Shockwave, guys. Shockwave it is. It wins out over my itty bitty heart. You hate to see it, huh? What's up, Mr. Peanut? Hey, man, Peanut, you killed it yesterday. Mr. Detective Peanut. Live in the flesh, buddy. We'll probably play some more Among Us later today. I'll duplicate for the feed here. That's too greedy. To dual wield defeat. If I dual wield defeat, this would have been really sick, actually. This would have been really sick to dual wield. I want to keep Sundial alive. Alright. I want to rest. Ooh, spot weakness is fantastic. Now we got some scaling. Do I rest for this fight? I think we rest for this fight. We don't want to risk anything, right? Although I do want to upgrade spot weakness and all that stuff, I don't want to risk anything. Dual wield for this turn would be great so I can get the Funeral Pain twice. Alright, never mind. Finally, Carnage is at a good price. By price, I mean cost. Do you guys like Raisin Bagels? Absolutely, man. I'm a huge fan of Raisin Bagels. I think people think I'm crazy for liking raisins in my cereal and in my bagels. But no, sir. I like me some Raisin Bagels. I wish people would like raisin stuff. Cinnamon Raisin Bagels is where it's at. And no one could tell me otherwise. Do we duplicate this, making this guy weaken for the rest of his life? Gotta be careful because I don't want this guy to die yet, because he could be he could summon again, so let's just do that. Oh wait, I killed him. Fuck. I just said the guy could summon again and I killed that because I forgot about bronze skills. Support my raisins? Wait, that sounds a little bit weird. I've heard that before from a girlfriend. It's okay, Jeremy, I support your little raisins. And now I'm kind of traumatized. Can you rephrase that, please? Cinnamon raisin English muffins are the shiz? I agree. Oatmeal is disgusting? No, oatmeal is not disgusting. You take that back right now. You take that back right now. If you're using Brazen Bagel, absolutely. Rough turn. Sec. The best place to go to the collector and kill him. See, this is why I didn't want to. This is why the Bronze Skills play actually was so bad for me. Because now he summoned a whole brand new minion that does 10 damage. That's 10 more damage I have to contend with. But yeah, I think we just have to go face on the collector here. 56, huh? I'm forced to use a potion. If anything was one cost deeper, I didn't have to use potion, but it's okay. So bludgeon in the Snekoi deck, Juggernaut or Berserk. You gain energy, but you gain vulnerable. We have a lot of max HP, so we can probably contend with the vulnerable over max HP. But bludgeon is like a big hit that oftentimes is a little bit cheaper. And that could be our damage for the fight. All we need is like a bludgeon, a carnage, and we're done. But here's the thing, we have spell weakness for scaling. Berserk gives me energy, which solves a lot of my issues. I think Berserk, although... See, now we don't really get an energy relic here, because I don't want to take Runic Dome. I'd rather take Card Draw or Remove here. I think removing two strikes is probably okay, but is Card Draw better, actually, from Runic Cube instead of Empty Cage? Because we're going to have Berserk giving us energy, plus Snekoi giving us Card Draw, and then Runic Cube gives us even more Card Draw. We're just removing the strikes so our deck is more clean. Alright. Now here's the problem. Berserk is still my only energy thing, so we need to find a way to mitigate it ASAP. So you know what would be huge right now? Pellets. Or Corruption. That works. Yeah, but the way we're gonna make Berserk work is it's never gonna cost more than zero. That's how you make it work. Overlay is called Info Mod. Ghostly Armor Speed Pot? Okay. I'll take the Ghostly Armor. Alright, what is this? Alright, buy one potion. Nice, alright. What is this? Alright, not bad. Why is Carnage so expensive? Alright, this is one of those bad turns for Berserk. This is one of them bad turns. You know one of them bad turns? This is it. This is one of them bad turns. But does it make my next turn better? I don't even think so. It doesn't even make my next turn better. I'm currently using Streamlabs. Thank you for using... You mentioned the word recording. Thank you. If I mentioned the word recording, I remembered to click record. Everybody, give a small clap for Villain. Does this make my next turn better? Yes. You don't upload villains. Well, in this case, you should. I just want to play feed, but it's not enough. Now I have to drop back into feed. Alright, drop back into feed. It's imperative. Nerve. It didn't happen. Is there a way to kill him without having to, like, do emo? Whatever. Wanted feed got burns instead. Palma Strike for card draw. Okay, what we need, honestly, though, guys, is, like, to solve energy. So our energy is still not solved. This Berserk is not the best solution for energy solving. Unless we get Momified Hand and we get... So unless we get Momified Hand and Orange Pellets, we haven't solved energy. Let's see what we get here. Gambling Chip is pretty good. Gambling Chip is pretty good, and so is... So is Toolbox, but Gambling Chip is really good, guys. Really good. He only appears to be a villain, exactly. It doesn't mean he actually is. Gambling Chip is powerful. We have Double Rupture. Honestly, I can bust, but I want to copy feed. Yeah, I want to copy. I got feed copy. Alright, boys. It's time to do double feed. We have to solve energy before time we get to the heart. That was a fantastic Sundial turn. I loved it. Wait, where's feed? Oh my god. Alright. I should have killed the other one in the middle so that he had more life. I didn't expect that. Why didn't I expect that? Whatever. Pommel versus Shrug It Off. He made a really good fire breathing deck. Nice. Alright, guys. Sparkle. We got Barricade. Shockwave is a little expensive here. Okay, that's a good Barricade. Alright, I can get down with it. Okay, I can get down with this. That's a good Barricade. If I got no rise, this run was like so much easier. I want to use my weakness, but at the same time, I want to get Berserk out. Berserk is rough here, but I think it's a necessary evil. So that the rest of the fight is easier. We got dual wield, but no... It's about weakness scaling. Yikes. I should have done this first. We're gonna lose Ghostly Armor. Yikes. Wait, we don't scale enough for this fight at all. I do not scale at all for this fight. Without spy weakness, I don't scale at all for this fight. This is a stream. This is a stream. This is live. If it was a video, it'd be very interesting that I'm responding to you live. Responding to you on a video before you even type it. Or, okay. Not before you type it, but you know what I mean. It would be very interesting if this was a video. Mechanic that makes all your costs cost one more too much to play against? Probably. That sounds annoying. Do I just have to feed now? Or do I do it with the feed to try to smack, and also get block out of it? Get Yushaku as well. It's too ready to feed for this fight, right? Let's get it out of the deck. Get as much damage, as much block as we can out of that, and get it out of the deck. This is a good spot weakness turn. Alright, it's not a bad turn. Alright, alright. We got some chances. We had some chances until this turn came around. We had chances. Okay, it's okay. We can rest. It's okay. We can rest, guys. It's all good. This is, is what resting is for. For moments like these. Alright, let's rest a little butt. Oh, Challenge Dasher is okay, not bad. Battle Trance is interesting because. Ah, pretty sure I'm an actor. I mean, entertainment on stream is sort of like acting. Like, you guys say jokes, and I have to pretend to laugh at them, you know what I mean? I'm just kidding. Oh, you guys are very funny. I love all the chat's jokes. Battle Trance, I don't know if I need. I mean, the cost of it's a little bit awkward. So I'm gonna go skip. Let's rest. Still gotta recall and I still gotta get the blue key. And I don't have any of the good relics that I wanted. I was 6 afraid of 7. Because 7, 8, 9. I couldn't laugh because Snake White did this turn to me. Like, how can I laugh at this? Wow. I'm gonna have to rest again. And I have to recall still. This deck is still not ready for the heart. It's not solved. Point where we're trying to make me laugh. Yeah, go for it, guys. Try making me laugh. Who's the funniest one in the chat right now? I just inted so hard. I just inted so hard. Oh man. Alright, I'm just throwing. I'm throwing. Let me focus up. I'm throwing really bad. I need like something crazy to bring me back here. Happy Flower is my energy solving. I had to get rid of it. I need something fantastic to bring me back. I'm throwing really bad right about now. Oh no. But I think I have to. We don't waste speed pop, right? I need that for the heart. I need artifact speed pop to win the heart. Hey, Marquette, appreciate it, buddy. I need to play the vulnerable as well, but I need. I need dual wield here. Damn. I need barricade in my deck. Aaron Curidian is the worst one you can get from that event. It's just official. Well, I need dual wield feed because I'm never going to feed. Now we're no longer vulnerable, but we have 4 energy, so Berserk paid off. Berserk is such a bad way to solve energy, but you know, it is what it is. It's what I'm currently using. It's what I currently have. Berserk in a dream. Spot weakness here? Is enough? Spot weakness enough? Alright, map time. Well, I lost my. I was thinking about my dog. Fuck. I was thinking about my dog. It's only 44. He's still gonna get some damage through. But if I do it like this, then it's 29, 29. 25, 25, 52. I like that better. Oh, the weaken made it. I was supposed to just use flame barrier. Oh, the weaken actually messed up my math. That's not fair. I think we threw this run. Dark Embrace is really good. I think I need another Flame Barrier in my deck. Nah, I think we need a Dark Embrace, right? That's gonna be very important to win this. Bloodletting doesn't really swap energy. I had a dream last night that I was fighting the Slime Boss IRL, and he was like using the goop to make me suck, and I couldn't move, and it was annoying. Damn, was my dream. Is my video like a nightmare that you had? I need Flame Barrier. I need a heal. Full heal. Full heal. There's a full heal event. I know there is. Dual wield feed? Dual wield feed? I played that turn wrong, actually. I might have to do seed pie here. I needed that for the heart. Corruption saved me. Corruption saved me. I don't know. I don't think it does enough because it might help, but I still need a recall. This elite has to save me. I have to beat the elite, and then this elite has to save me in terms of the relic it gives me. So, for some time, I was using the old Streamlabs, and in the old Streamlabs, the chat, video chat was stopped working. So now I switched over to the people kept asking about the video, and for a good reason, I respect that. Since they were asking me about that, I decided to switch over to new Streamlabs, and everything works on the new Streamlabs, so the chat's back there. But for some time, I was using the old Streamlabs, and there was no chat. And for that, I apologize. But there should be chat for every video to come. I need feed on this guy. Nah, it wasn't a choice. Alright, this elite. Okay, the cult deposit is good. This elite has to be a really good relic. Corruption early. Is corruption early worth it? Combust is really good, though. I need to get combust out. That's the thing. Ah. Combust is too good. Well, corruption is really good with Charon's Ashes, so. If we do this. I didn't get to get Final Pain out because everything was 3 costs, but Combust is going to be really important. I have to do Berserk. I'm going to be vulnerable, but it's a necessary evil. It's a necessary evil to play Berserk here. Oh, maybe I could have got away with not playing it, honestly. Maybe I could have got away with not playing it. Now that I think about it. Yeah, because I could have killed him this turn regardless. I didn't have to play it. Why did I play Berserk when I had Corruption in play? I made a huge mistake. I had to recall. There's no Pantograph. Alright, boys. Wish me luck. No Pantograph in a dream. I think we do it with Juggernaut, and that's how we kill him. I think we do it with Juggernaut, that's how we win. Advice comes, this is fine. Do I have to do Cultist Spire for this fight? Maybe, right? I'm doing good for Willis Hiding, buddy. So our weakness is important. Getting bust out of the deck is probably pretty important. Getting Berserk for more energy is not bad, although we have Ice Cream. The vulnerable is really rough, though. The vulnerable is too rough, right? But he's gonna make me vulnerable anyways, actually. So then I'm gonna have it vulnerable for an extended amount of time, but the energy is too important. The weaken is really important, but it's cost 3 of my energy. I don't. The stream schedule, I usually go live around this time. Final Pain is really important for Juggernaut. I'm back to my house for the first time in a while today, and they were deep cleaning, so I was forced to come back home. Good times. It'll get better soon. I can't kill him here, can I? Okay, with Juggernaut, how much damage do I actually have? With Juggernaut and Final Pain, don't I do 20 damage per block? Plus Charon's, I do 23 damage per block. I have 7 cards, I do 23 damage per block. Is this lethal? 23 damage per block. That's crazy. So 23, 46. It's not enough. I am considering Final Pain. That's why I had 23 damage per block. Because it procs twice. So 81. This is going to be 10 plus 20. 13 plus 23 is another 36. So 90, 97. Nah, not even close. I want to keep Carnage though. I hope it was Ledge again. Yeah, I wouldn't mind. I need to prevent any more life here. I think getting feet is actually really important in this fight. But... I don't want to leave myself with two cards. I think feet is getting really important though. But I don't want to leave myself with two cards. This is really awkward. This is extremely awkward. I don't want to waste this potion either. I'm going to need it for the next boss fight because I need to just survive this next boss fight. And I think I need to get feet off in order to... Leave myself with two cards is really bad. How do I rectify this? Ah. If I use the potion, then I can get feet in this fight. If I use the potion, I don't have it for the next fight. Which might be necessary. If I let it go through and I have two cards next turn, two cards, and I may not be able to block enough. So I can't get feet in this fight. Getting feet would be so important though. Every little bit of life matters. We've discussed this already. Ah, he wasn't attacking. If I knew that, if I knew he wasn't attacking, then I would have just passed. But you can't know these things. No feet for me. Alright, we gotta survive this. This is tough because I have a lot of powers. The powers are very important. It's a tough fight for me. I think spot weakness is gonna be very important for this fight. I think we can't play Rupture though. The weakness is very important, but I'd rather play Shockwave. I think spot weakness is very important. I don't think we play this. I think we play Berserk. I think it's worth it, but I'm about to take a lot of damage. I'm about to play a lot of damage with Berserk. I think we use this potion now because it's important that... Wait, what if the potion plays Corruption or one of these powers? Does that fuck me? If the potion plays Corruption or one of these powers, it fucks me, right? But I need to kill these minions now and I need to get feed value, I think. I'm going to be more thinking it. I can't play any of my powers, which is really rough for this fight. I gotta get rid of this phase immediately. I played a Feral Pain, but I don't mind that. I should have done Spot Weakness first. But that's really good, because now I get an extra energy here, so I could do... do I even play Berserk, though? The energy is helpful, but we have Ice Cream, right? Berserk is probably too risky. I gotta save energy here, but if I play Berserk, I could finish this turn with True Grit, and only next turn will I be vulnerable. But, and then from the rest of the problem is he gets strength from Berserk as well. And I don't have a way to manage multi-attacks that well, and I don't know if I'm fast enough, because I don't have Ritual Cultist Pot, which I use for the Time Eater. I don't have Cultist Pot. And all I have is my weakness for scaling. I can't play Berserk right now. The multi-attack is too rough. I haven't played Shockwave yet. Dewey with Feral Pain would be good for... So Dewey with Feral Pain is really good after this phase is done. Because once this phase is done, if I can do a lot of Funeral Pain and then have Corruption, I can finish off the fight with Funeral Pain from block with Corruption. But right now, there's too many powers. So I would say that Hemokinesis is actually quite important here because I want to kill this thing ASAP. But I need to play Ghostly Armor. It's one of my only block cards. And fortunately, that's all I can do. Alright, hopefully that's the worst of it. I just gonna be doing some work here. Hopefully that's the worst of it. I need to keep the weaken on him at all times. I don't really want to waste Carnage on him. Carnage is one of my best damage cards, so I don't really want to waste it on... Alright, I think this turn I have to just waste Carnage. Unless I let Carnage go down. And then Sharon's Ashes plus that kills him. And I have full block. Wait, how much block do I have? I have 16. 24. If I do spot weakness, Carnage, clothesline, I take 10. This way, if I do 24, I take 6. Take 4 more damage this way, but I keep Carnage in the deck. If I do it this way, I take 4 less damage. Carnage is out of the deck. Actually, I take only 1 damage because of the Funeral Pain. I take only 1 damage and Carnage is out of the deck, but that's like my best damage card in order to kill him. Like my only damage card in order to kill him. And I need that to kill this guy quickly. So that I can get to the next phase, play my powers, and hopefully win with Corruption. So, hey, that's awesome from Danyu. Maybe I don't play Spot Weakness now and I start a full block. Life is more important. Even though I need the scaling really bad. This would be a really good turn to do Funeral Pain, dual wield. But again, like I said, I have to wait. So I have to do more damage somehow. Luckily, we got some good block. If we keep him weakened and we keep blocking like this, Flame Barrier will carry us. So we have to keep him weakened. The problem is, I have to lose Carnage now. Carnage or Ghostly Armor, I gotta make a decision. I don't have energy for both. Alright, we have to lose Carnage and Ghostly Armor. We have to lose literally both. So we're gonna have to just Flame Barrier our way to victory here. And we didn't get Flame Barrier. Not getting Flame Barrier is really bad here. Spot Weakness is pretty important, but I need to save energy. Alright. Flame Barrier way to victory is possible. It's possible. This is actually important because it gives me Nunchaku and it increases the vulnerable, which is important. Clothesline is ultra important. I keep taking the incidental damage here, but like, I don't want to waste 3 energy on defense. So we take 2 damage here. And if I could do it with Funeral Pain Plus with the next phase, that'd be fantastic. Flame Barrier offense here. I think we need to get rid of Hemokinesis. I don't want to use it. And that it allows us to get more consistent Flame Barriers. I don't have enough life to even use that card. And this allows me to get consistent Flame Barriers as my offense. The main problem is, guys, it's going to have to be really important to do with Funeral Pain for the next phase. As well as be able to block 40 damage. It's a tough task. I got a full block here. This is bad though because I did not play Berserk this fight. Alright, we got double Flame Barrier. That's really good. It's really good offense. Really good. All right, the flame bear offense is working. The only problem is I need to time up actually Sundial again for the turn where I had to block for 40. So I have to trigger it again. Because I have to make it so that I'm drawing into double flame bear for the 40 attack, because that's too much for me. So this double flame bear, this turn of block, I need this for the turn where he's attacking next phase, which is kind of tough. So the math is kind of finicky here. This would actually kill him, but I need to set up flame bear one more time. But he's gonna die to the multi-hit anyways, actually. He's gonna take 15 here. That kills him. And I don't necessarily want to kill him, actually. Because this is not the turn that I need for the following turn. I need to get 40 block, so I can't kill him here yet. But now I also gotta be mindful that I can die here very easily. I feel like at this point we're not gonna be able to do Berserk. Matter of fact, we might just be dead here. One is being a dream, it's possible. I've won games like this before. I got the dual wield, but not the right I don't get the right power, so if I don't get dual wield on Phenoplane, I don't think I can win at all, actually. And if I don't play Corruption now, then the next phase is rough. This is just tragic, actually, all around. I can make sure that he dies in the first hit of multi-hit. Or the second hit, rather. So I actually don't take too much damage. But the problem is, then I don't get to play Corruption of Dual Wield, and the next turn I have to make sure I have enough block, which I should be able to, because I have Clothesline coming up, and I have Flame Barrier. I'm never going to have time to play Berserk, because I can never be vulnerable. Oh, since he dies like that? Alright. I think I had to play Phenoplane here. But I think Dual Wield Phenoplane is so important to win this next fight. Okay, this is all the block that I wanted for the following turn, and I didn't... Ooh, this is okay, though, because we actually have Flame Barrier and Clothesline. I can't play Combust, so I gotta get rid of that. But also, I really want Dual Wield Phenoplane, but I think that... I can't greed that, can I? Can I greed that? Because Corruption has to carry me for the second half of the fight. It's probably too greedy. At least I still have a Flame Bearer here. And a Clothesline. I can avoid trigger. If I do trigger on defend, I draw into my flame barriers more often, which is my best defense. But then I have more cards that I gotta worry about, like strike. And I gotta get rid of this combust. So I don't know if I want to trigger my defense here. I'm not sure. But this is totally possible. So I have 14 strength now. If I get rid of my defense, I draw into my flame bears more often, but then I also draw into all the shitty cards more often as well. Well, Corruption's gonna get rid of them anyways. So getting rid of these things when Corruption's gonna take care of it anyways is, I think, a bad decision. We gotta keep all the skills we can for Corruption to get as much value as possible out of the exhaust. And it's in this moment where we need to play Corruption, probably, to fully maximize our value out of our skills. So one block per turn. And then, like, allows us to put more of our energy into attacks with this amount of strength to spot weakness. Can imagine our attacks are actually getting quite close to lethal. So Corruption here just allows us to play one skill to defend and mainly attack, and then we should be able to push for lethal here. So I'm thinking I actually Corruption now, but then yes, it also does a lot of damage with Shards. Do I want to get spot weakness again? I think I do want to be able to see that again, so I'll do this. I can just play one of those. Do I do with Thunderclap so I have more vulnerable? And just more attacks? And I don't want to see dual wield again. I'm fine with this. Sundial's coming. So I can just get rid of one thing and just do... This allows me to attack like that. I'll start setting up my Jaco for the next fight. The Act 4 Elite. I didn't get to set up Sundial for Act 4 Elite, but whatever. That was very scary. Alright, I need to buy potions for the heart, and I need a better relic, man. This deck is struggling. I think I need Fairy in the Bottle. Are there any upgrades that are worth it more than like 20, 31 HP? Alright, there's a world where I actually really want to upgrade Berserk, because getting the energy from Berserk is really important. And then I get the vulnerable out of the way. But, you know, that would be vulnerable anyways against the heart. Oh, it doesn't become an 8. What am I talking about? It becomes 1 vulnerable. What am I talking about? It doesn't become an 8. Yeah, I think we're going to have to go ahead and rest. Although I do have Burning Blood. What upgrade is really important? Okay. Funeral Pain is a very good important upgrade. And so is Dual Wield. Because Dual Wield can hit me in Caridian. I can just win the game. And Funeral Pain is my main block, but 31 HP versus... Okay, this actually is only technically 29 HP. 29 HP versus a Funeral Pain upgrade. What's more important? This deck is using my face as a resource. I have a lot of max HP, 139, and it has some scaling with spot weakness. It has some tangential block with things like Funeral Pain and exhaust energies through Corruption and Funeral Pain and Sharon's Ashes. And it has utility like Weaken. Like Weaken from Shockwave, Weaken from Clothesline, and things like Flame Barrier for multi-hit damage. That's literally all it has. 29 HP versus Funeral Pain. How is Funeral Pain plus more than 29 life? Let's think about that. How is Funeral Pain plus more than 29 life? I need to play 29 cards to get more value out of it. Am I going to exhaust 29 cards? Yeah, Sad Machine, I hate that. I absolutely hate that. Are you back in town? Welcome, how was your vacation? Alright, guys. The shop has to be something good. I need orange pellets. Okay. Alright. Speed pot is good. I need to get it. Okay, speed pot is good, and so is power pot. And, I need to get a potion from the elite. Speed pot and power pot are good. I need artifact. I need artifact for speed pot, and I can win this game. Power pot needs to be barricade, and I win this game. Power pot can be demon form, and I win this game. I need a lot. I need both of these. And then, do I get another True Grit or nah? It was vacation. I was watching my sister's 4 kids. Okay, that does not sound like vacation. 4 kids is a lot of kids to watch. Do I buy a True Grit here? I think we need both of these. Both of these for sure. The question is, do I need the True Grit or not? Or like another Shrug It Off or another skill. Another Corruption skill. True Grit manages burns, but it's not upgraded. Yeah, our RP hand. Yeah, Trigger doesn't... It's not upgraded, which is a little bit awkward, but, you know, the Warp Tongs should upgrade it eventually. Alright, I think it's better. Let's go. Deck is 27 cards. Pretty lean. Dark Embrace is fantastic for this fight. Whoa, very good hand. Human Kinesis, I don't want. Clothesline, I don't need. Clothesline helps with Shockwave, though. We found Berserk. Okay. Shockwave real quick. I should have maybe kept close then, but I don't have the energy for all that. Berserk is rough because I don't want to be vulnerable in these 2 turns. It's not that turns I want to be vulnerable, but like at the same time the energy helps immensely. That means next turn I'm gonna be vulnerable. And this is why you upgrade Berserk for things like this, right? I'm gonna be vulnerable next turn. Is it more important to actually try to kill Spire Shield here? I don't know. It's possible. I have card draw from Snake away. Stream's alive. Stream should be live. Stream should be live, right? You guys can't see me? Okay. I'm trying to think. Getting invulnerable next turn is really rough, huh? Man, why is Berserk so awkward? Oh, Steam's down. Damn, that sucks. What did it draw? Drew another flame bearer. I needed that next turn. I need calipers. I can't get feet off here. Am I supposed to do speed pie here, or I need to save it for the heart? If they drop a potion, speed pie is worth it here. Speed pie is just really good here. I can't really afford to do corruption now, right? But I mean, I do have Sharon's Ashes. But if I do corruption, how do I get lethal? Draw through my whole deck. I'm doing a lot of damage with like bronze skills and Charon's Ashes. It's doing a lot of work actually. It's doing a lot of work. Doing quite a bit of work actually. Keeping vulnerable on him, I think, is pretty important for next turn. Nah, GG. I waste speed pop, but if they drop a potion, it's totally worth. So, corruption saved me here basically. Let's see if I can get Nunchaku stacks because. I actually want to keep Sundial proc. Alright. Give me a potion, give me a potion, give me a potion. Okay, something. Infernal Blade can give me potential. Nothing, this is not it. Rupture. Rupture can be strength scaling. Strength scaling from Hemokinesis. Nah, that's really not it. Alright. 141 HP in a dream. We have a Power Pot, it's also a dream. Got barricade. Yo! Alright. I deep berserk now, I'm already being vulnerable. I get the value out of it already. I deep berserk now, I get the vulnerable. I got shockwave, which is fantastic. I got the weaken, I'm good. Berserk is giving me one extra turn of vulnerable, but the extra turn of vulnerable doesn't mean shit to me actually because I have a free turn that turn, so I think I do berserk, and then I have energy for the rest of the fight. Yo, we don't get the spot weakness, which is unfortunate, but I think we see what power we get here. Yo, we got demon form. I just won the game. Dark Embrace is very good too, but demon form is also just really good. Wow, man. These little RNG elements make all the difference. Wow, now the max HP farming that I did the whole game is all relevant. Everything's relevant. Yeah, I'll take Demon Form. GG. Either lose Carnage, but that's fine. Demon Form gives me this strength now. Yeah, I think it's probably weakness scaling at some point, but I need to trigger the burn stuff and the wounds. I don't do corruption now, but double flame barrier here is disgusting. Look at this flame barrier offense. Jeez. I didn't get dual wield here. I would like to get dual wield. I should have played Hemokinesis there. My bad. That was just free attack. I fucked that up. I need to play. Oh, close. This is perfect. Bash close. That is perfect. Because I need to get the weaken for the next couple attacks. This is perfect. Absolutely perfect. Now he's weakened for the rest of the these turns. Let me get Flame Barrier again. Got Flame Barrier times two again, brother. I'm talking again. And I want to keep it, so I do Corruption after the fact. And that's how we win this right here. Because we want to keep the Flame Barriers for the next attack. And now we do Corruption. Just killing him with Flame Barrier. This is the incidental damage, the Flame Barrier, the Bronze Skills, the Charon's Ashes is doing so much work this fight. This run. Weaken again. So clean. I want to hit the burn. I'm gonna save Flame Barrier for this next turn. You guys ready? I'm not gonna worry about feed. Let's save Flame Barrier for this next turn. I'm gonna get all three Flame Barriers. You ready? All three Flame Barriers. All three. I only got one. It looks sketchy. Awake One almost killed me. And we ended up with literally a perfect hard fight. It's crazy. Power Pie was the MVP. So was Incuridian. And Gamership was clutch too. Beautiful. It's a beautiful run.